The Delta State women's basketball team wraps up preseason games on Monday, December 2nd, as the Lady Statesmen travel to Payne College in Augusta, Georgia. For the team's final non-conference game at Walter Sillars Coliseum, DSU welcomed fellow Mississippi school Belhaven University to Cleveland on November 26th. Second-year head coach David Midlick looking to keep the winning ways going against Belhaven. The Lady Statesmen come out, hit their first 7 shots. Randy Ball with the short jumper here. DSU is up 5-0. This time, it's Mary Carol Davis. She fakes out the defender, pulls up at the foul line, 7-3, Delta State. Lady Statesmen out and running here. Chelsea Rhodes drives in, banks in the shot, 7-point lead for DSU. Ball again, not a defender in sight, hits the short jumper. Belhaven calls a timeout, and it's 11-2, Lady Statesmen. Rhodes started the game off with a 3. She gets another here. Delta still has not missed. DSU up 14-2. Becca Rux keeping that streak alive. She calls for the ball, gets it, makes the bucket. 14-point lead for the Lady Statesmen. The hot shooting streak stops there, but the scoring doesn't. Seneca Walton with the turnaround jumper. DSU up 18-5 in the first half. About 10 minutes still to play. Rux again here, catches it at the foul line, then drives for the score, and she draws a foul. Rhodes with the ball later on. She takes on the defender. Crossover dribble, then a turnaround jumper. It's good. Delta has a 20-point lead. Heading into the locker room, DSU leads Belhaven 45-20. Second half action now. Guess who? Rhodes drives baseline. It's now 53-27, Lady Statesmen. Shanae Govan just keeps dishing out assists. This one to Anissa Jackson in the corner. 28-point lead for Delta State. Jackson again with about 3 minutes to play and from pretty much the same spot. The Delta State women go on to beat Belhaven 64-42.
First, excited about it. I think Belhaven is a very good team. 22 Ariel Wilson is an excellent freshman. They have some pretty good wing players and post players that can both post up and put the basketball on the floor. So we came out really well in the first half. I think hit our first 7 shots, got some momentum, got some confidence. But it was a tale of two halves. Coach Cram is an excellent coach, went to a zone, was not going to let us get the basketball into our post players, and we turned the basketball over, I think, 15 times, Phillip said, and 6-for-24 from the field. So we have some work to do, and we'll go to work on it. We've been working on that. We know teams are going to do that, and we'll continue to work on it.
Coach Midlick wasn't kidding about this being a tale of two halves. Delta State outscored Belhaven 45-20 in the first half, but without that lead, this game could have been a very different story. In the second half, it was Belhaven that outscored the Lady Statesmen 22-19.
A team like Belhaven is going to continue to get confidence if the game is close, just like any team will on the road. I mean, it'd be the same thing with us when we play on the road, and they have they have some weapons. And we knew starting the second half that they would probably adjust, and that also Ariel Wilson, 22, would be back in the game after her two foul.
Chelsea Rhodes led DSU with 16 points. The reigning Gulf South Conference Freshman of the Year is performing exactly how Coach Midlick wants her to.
Without a doubt. I feel confident that when she shoots the basketball, it's going to go in. I'm surprised when it doesn't go in. And she has the green light in most cases to shoot the basketball. And she struggled in the Stillman game shooting the ball. I believe she was 4-for-12. And we've gotten a lot of shots up in the last 2 days and just tweaked some mechanics a little bit. And she looked good shooting the basketball tonight.
Inside power, Seneca Walton only scored 2 points, but she pulled down 10 rebounds. Fellow post player Becca Rux was good for 10 points, though, and 8 rebounds.
Great to have two if, you know, foul trouble, if one's not having their best game offensively, and it's great sometimes to play both of them. We've tried some combinations where both of them have been in at the same time and try to play a little high-low game and pound the ball inside. And we tried that in the second half, and they adjusted to it, and we had to hit some mid-range shots and some outside shots, and we just didn't.
The first Gulf South Conference game for the Delta State women is just around the corner. It will be a trip to Christian Brothers in Memphis on December 14th.
Well, you know, it's the same thing, Peggy, we talked about all along. We've turned the ball over too much, and we fouled too much. The first half, they only had 3 field goals, but they had 14-for-21 from the free throw line. We are fouling entirely too much, and we're turning the basketball over too much. We can practice that as much as possible, but You know, that's a lot of game situation stuff. We'll practice footwork stuff. We'll practice passing drills. We'll practice our offense. We'll practice defense with towels and call fouls in practice. But we just have to do it in the game.
Knowing what needs to get done before GSC play, Coach Midlick says he still thinks the team is headed in the right direction this season.
Proud of them. Even with the second half not being good today, we've gotten better, I think, every week, and it showed in the first half tonight. I don't think 2 weeks ago we would have been up at half 45-20 on a team the caliber of Belhaven. So we've improved, but we have a long way to go, as the second half showed. So we can't be complacent. We'll continue to work.
For GoStatesman.com, I'm Katie Smith.